In this video, I bring to you 6 reasons why Ashes cricket is better than Don Bradman cricket 17 and 14. So let's get started. Reason number 1. Better batting controls. I've extensively played Don Bradman cricket 14 and 17, and one thing I can say surely is that batting has a really steep learning curve in those games, mainly for 2 reasons. The first reason is that for someone who's used to playing EA Sports cricket games, the timing for Don Bradman series is completely different. And the second reason for the steep learning curve is that the controls don't feel very natural or intuitive. It takes quite a while to get used to them and can be frustrating to learn, especially for casual players. Ashes cricket introduces a new batting style where you can take control of the direction by the left stick and choose the shot type by using different buttons. It took a day or two for me to get used to the new controls, but now when I look at them, they seem to be very natural and intuitive. I feel it's easier to time the ball this time, and this is really great for everyone. Reason number 2. Better bowling controls. Just like the batting, even the bowling had very challenging and tedious control in the previous games. Especially when it came to spin bowling, it was just difficult to wrap your head around it. Ashes Cricket 17 introduces new type of bowling controls that are a lot easier. While I'm so used to the older controls now that I prefer them, non-hardcore fans can really enjoy the new bowling controls without having to put hours into learning them. Reason number 3. Better algorithm for batting shots. One of the reasons that made Don Bradman cricket series great is its unpredictability. However, sometimes it was just too unstable. I had times when I played a shot with all 3 meters, that is the timing, shot type and footwork, being ideal or at least good, and I still got an edge and got out. This happened very frequently with spinners when I was trying to drive them, no matter how set I was. Now, the 3 things I can control, if I'm doing them right, I can't expect to get out again and again. And the funny part was that sometimes having poor shot selection or footwork would not generate an edge. This seems to have been corrected in the Ashes cricket game. There seems to be no random chance algorithm at work this time, and I feel well rewarded for getting my shots right and penalized for having poor shot selection, and that is the way it should be. Reason number 4. Field map. This is seriously the best thing ever. In the previous games, there being no field map, I would have to look around the field to see where the fielders are. The AI would sometimes change the field every ball. So it was very frustrating to have a look again and again to see which fielders have gone where. With the field map in place, it saves a lot of time, and one look is enough to know where or where not the fielders are. And if you like the older way of playing, you can always turn this option off. Reason number 5. Different bowling and batting styles. To be honest, I was tired of looking at the same style of batting and bowling in DBC 14 and 17 over and over again. It got very monotonous after a while. Ashes Cricket 17 has different styles of batting and bowling which keep it fresh and fun. Reason number 6. Officially licensed teams. Ashes Cricket has officially licensed women's and men's teams for England and Australia. They have motion captured the players to bring them to life. It feels as if you're controlling the real life player, so that is the good part. However, this comes last in the list because it is just 2 teams. It would have been much better if all the teams were licensed, but it's still better than nothing, to be honest. I know you can always download the players from the community, but it just doesn't give that realistic feel that licensed teams do. So that's it. These are 6 reasons why I think Ashes cricket is better than previous games. Which ones do you guys agree or disagree with? Have I missed some good points? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to write an email to the president of your country telling him to smash the like button, and also tell them to subscribe to my channel. Cheers. Thank you.